Oh, everybody, Rag Takes Agni here. Welcome to the next episode. In the last episode, we played as Raphael. Let's see who we play as today. Let's see. We've done a good portion of the roster right now, but need to double check who I have and haven't done, but let's go for the last bonus character, Agor Fear.
Let's measure your strength!
Once there was a man who, despite overlot, I've and the world, created the distant heavens to curse all existence at the moment of his death. While alive, the man had distinguished himself as a prophet. By achieving a momentary connection to the vast anomals of history, he had slept in the abyss of chaos. The abyss of the cosmos. My bad. He was able to learn about events from the past and future in great detail, but maintained as he was in a deep despair and resentment. The man he used supernatural links in an attempt to send his regrets into the core of the universe, until at last, he made a pact with the will of the cosmos, destroyed the degenerate planet Earth. Without giving the matter any further thought, the will of the cosmos made its decision. The world would be destroyed after a 500-year grace period. During that time, Earth's doomed inhabitants would try to change their wicked ways. However, no sooner than the man died, the Earth received a visitor, and while he was a marshal in direct service of the will of cosmos, entrusted with the power to punish it on its behalf, she did not. She had not, strictly speaking, had been tasked with the Earth's destruction. Instead, she descended upon the Earth to investigate 500 years from now. And when one was tasked to destroy the planet arrived, would he or she find Earth, this land where swords, spirits, and curse wage endless battle worthily? And depending on what she found there, there might be no need to wait for the appointed executioners to arrive. The day she judged Earth unworthy, why, that would be the day of judgment. Arrival. We got Yangzhong, Tilem, and Songmia.
When two warriors cross paths, a battle must ensue.
I'm not gonna let up for a second!
Fool, you dare to stand up to me?
Yeah, so she very stands out compared to the cast. She looks very anime. Which I think is fitting, because I believe the guest artist that did this bonus character is an anime artist, I believe? I want him. I think so? Anyway. Ooh, perfect. She borrows heavily from Songmia's moveset, so she's pretty much a Songmia. I will say I love the look of her weapon, though. Perfect. Gonna fight Songmia herself. Ooh, I broke her chest. Oh, couldn't get perfect three times in a row.
That did amuse me for a while.
You have captured Young Song as a sample of a local specimen. I forgot that's how she recruits one of these people. So I guess I have captured you to be my specimen. Also, help me fight my battles. So we got Killik, Chengba, and Amy.
Countless warriors have cast themselves into battle for the cursed sword.
I will show you the power of discipline.
So, you refuse to listen. Very well.
Stage, start.
Tia! I'll catch you!
Kilik.
Tia!
Take this!
Nothing perfect! Ow, 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 ow.
I'll catch you!
Sweep the legs. Ooh, alright, broke her chest. Oh, I was hoping she would go into the pit.
Ring out.
Ooh, yep. Amy. Oh, we traded there. Down Amy goes.
Stage completed.
Don't enter a battle you can't win.
The Colt's Vanguard. Time to face Aslotti.
A formidable opponent awaits.
What are you so afraid of?
Stage start.
Also, the more I think about it, her looking very anime-ish definitely fits that she's supposed to be an extraterrestrial because, yeah, she doesn't fit in Earth's aesthetics. I just thought about that during the cutscene.
KO!
Stage completed. Don't enter a battle you can't win.
Young Strong has ran away! The first sin. So we got sick. Ooh, four people this time. Siegfried, Hyde, that girl, and then Ivy.
Determination, obsession, hope. The fiery emotions illuminate the two swords.
I will remove all obstacles in my path.
You're in my way. Stand aside.
Stage start.
First beat of Siegfried.
Perfect.
Nice, perfect him. Now here comes Hyde.
Be gone.
Oh, ow. Toss you into the floor.
Measure your strength!
Slam Ivy onto the floor.
KO!
And down she goes.
You risk your life and that's all you got?
That was quite entertaining. You have done well. This shall be my first battle in ages. You are a worthy opponent. Strong one, you shall be the sacrifice. For my resurrection!
Agor! Let's take him on.
The curtain has been raised. Those chosen by history begin their final battle.
Let's measure your strength!
I will destroy any that stand in my way!
Stage start.
Beat him up.
Parried me. Slam you down on the floor. Whoa. Okay, that was kind of cool.
I'll crush you.
Not doing too well. Ooh, don't you send me down flying off the tower. Oh, he is angry today. And Novi ring out prevented him from being ringed out, and down he goes.
Challenge me
stage
again if you dare.
The stunned life is unable to control the colossal power it's given. It's give life to. The strife seem incurred, the naive and the foolish. If mankind was only being on this planet, she would have brought judgment without any hesitation. But there are numerous other lives on the planet that are unswayed by others and live in peace. After serving all, Agor Fear headed home. The planet will prove no problems for the executioner, for that girl. But if mankind destroyed all before or the time comes, when that time comes, she will be ready to give them a fitting end. And with that, we are done with Agor Fear. So I'll leave you to the credits and we'll see who we play as in the next episode. So if you enjoyed this episode, do like the videos, it helps tremendously. Subscribe if you haven't already, leave a comment down below on your thoughts of this episode, and share the videos, that way more people can discover my content, help the channel grow, and I will see you all next time. Later.